focus first on your efforts to communicate with the White House, with the executive branch, because I know that you have concerns along all those lines. You've written the White House or Justice Department, haven't you, sir?
I have. I think we have five, beginning back in early December, requesting information or suggesting how that these terrorists should be handled. And we've got not a single response from any one of them.
All right. I asked you to get the letter scheduled. Let's go to the first one, because I think it's so intriguing that the efforts made to get information, whether you agree with the executive branch or not, that the lack of ability to sort of get a reply is interesting. But the first one was sent to whom and what date?
Well, on December 9th, I wrote to them really challenged the statements twice made by Attorney General Holder that the Saudi rehabilitation program, where we release prisoners from Guantanamo, we send them to Saudi Arabia, they were supposed to rehabilitate them before they released them. We found that that's not working. Two of the key people that were involved in sending the Christmas Day bomber to the United States with the bomb on his person, that were people who'd gone through the Saudi program, had been in Guantanamo, been released, went to Yemen, and then helped coordinate this attack on the United States.
All right, did you get any response back? I guess, who was the letter sent to?
That was Eric Holder, the Attorney General, and we got no response whatsoever.
Not even like, Senator, thanks for your letter, we got it, we'll think about it, or we don't agree with you. You got zero response.
Zero response.
When was the next communication about any of these issues in writing?
January 8th, we wrote to the president, a group of, I think, 22, and we talked about the Christmas Day bomber, and we expressed concern about the trial of this case in civilian court, and we thought it represented a pre-9/11 mentality. Which was that we would treat attackers on the United States as normal criminals. 9/11 Commission and the nation really decided we were at war and we needed to treat this at war. So we challenged that.
All right, and now that you obviously have a substantive difference with the administration, because the administration made a different decision. But I'm curious, did you receive any response to that particular communication, like, Senator, thanks a lot for writing, we disagree with you, or whatever? Any communication in writing or phone call, anything from the White House?
No communication.
Nothing.
No
and how many U.S. senators on that?
I think 22 on that.
Okay. And your next communication then?
To Secretary Janet Napolitano. It dealt with the plans and the funding Congress provided to have some special FBI agents in dangerous areas of the world to help the State Department do background checks on people before they're given visas to the United States.
What date is that letter to?
January 14th.
Are you the single, how many people, how many senators signed that?
There's seven of us, the Senate Judiciary Committee members, Republicans, all signed that letter.
Did Secretary Napolitano acknowledge receipt of that letter?
No.
Nothing?
We've received nothing to my knowledge and no response to my knowledge from that. Then on January 21st, the Senate Judiciary Republicans, seven, wrote to Attorney General Holder to ask who made the decision within the Department of Justice on really the night of the arrest of the Christmas Day bomber to try him in civilian court, to advise him of his rights, to tell him they were appointing a lawyer for him, and to really allow that interrogation to end. Who made that decision?
Get a response?
No response.
Now, has anyone testified before Congress on those particular issues so that they could say that, you've gotten your answer?
Yes. FBI Director Mueller testified, and I pressed him on this question. He said that he was not made personally aware of it. He said, we also learned that the intelligence agency heads were not, and neither was the Secretary of Defense. And he said an official in the Department of Justice, it appears in Washington, not at the local level, made that decision. And I said, who? And he said, I think you should ask the Department of Justice. So we wrote this letter and received no response from that.
And then there's another letter.
And this was January 26th to Attorney General Holder, and it dealt with the Christmas Day attack. This one was led by Senator McConnell. Senator Susan Collins, a ranking Republican on Homeland Security, John McCain, ranking on Defense, Kit Vaughn, ranking on Intelligence, and myself, ranking on Judiciary, and to follow up as to who made the decision about the civilian trial for the Christmas Day bomber, and we received no response from that.
Is that sort of the way business is done? I'm trying to understand whether this is an anomaly, although we've spoken to a Congressman Roe who has sent a series of communications on an unrelated issue to the White House and gotten no response. Is this sort of, you know, the way it's done, that the Senate fires off letters to various agencies in the White House and doesn't expect an answer back, or is this something different?
I think this is quite different. Well, I think it's something we're entitled to a response to. We're asking questions on behalf of the American people. I've been elected to represent my people. American people are not happy about these trials in civilian courts, and they'd like to know why and what's happening. And I think the administration owes us a response to those questions.
What do you think their view is? Just like, we don't have to answer these, or go ahead and, you know, we'll go up to Capitol Hill and testify? I mean, you know, how, because I tell you, most American people think, well, you know, you send these letters, you should at least get some sort of response like, no, yes, we got it, or something.
Perhaps they, number of things. They hadn't made up their mind what the right answer is. Maybe they don't have a good answer. Maybe they think it'll just go away, but it's not going away. We're going to get these answers sooner or later, but it would be much better if we got them sooner.